पीपल जस्ट एक्सपेक्ट यू टू नो एवरी थिंग दैट देर इज अबाउट एवरी डैम सब्जेक्ट एंड एवरी सिंगल डिसीज दैट इज देर इन दिस वर्ल्ड. नो, वी डू नॉट लर्न टू टेक एन इंजेक्शन सून आफ्टर एंटरिंग अ कोर्स. Hey everybody, so welcome back to my channel. I'm back with another video and this is a little different. It's about myths about MBBS. I'm an MBBS student, final year, and let's get started. So the first myth that I want to bust is that people think you need to be a topper in your school or your college to get into MBBS. Not true. It all depends on your entrance exam and your college marks are not taken at all for your admissions. So even an average student can do very well in an entrance exam and get through to MBBS. It all depends on how hard you work. So they say that you will not have a social life if you join MBBS. Not true, guys. If you were a social person in the beginning, from the beginning, like you still will make time to meet your friends, hang out with them, go out for a drink, go for a trip, or just hang out with your family, everything. And you will not turn into an introvert. But if you were an introvert from before, probably you'll just remain the same. It's again all about time management and even your hobbies. You need not give up on them. You can still pursue them and just make time for everything and manage everything properly. So another question that I get a lot is about the 5.5 year mystery. Let me just tell you that it's 4.5 year course with 1 year of internship and second year has 1.5 years. So that's that. Something really funny that I get asked quite often is, what did you specialize in? Let me just clear this and put it out there that MBBS is an undergraduate course and you're not specializing in anything. After MBBS, you take up a post-graduation, maybe an MD, maybe an MS, anything in a particular subject, and that is where you specialize. This is especially for those toppers of your school or your college who have been scoring 95% above. Do not expect that once you enter medical college, you're going to be scoring the same way. Because in a medical college, you are never getting 90 above. And if you get 75 above, you're considered a very intelligent, super intelligent student. So keep that in mind and get that set so that you don't expect and then you feel sad about it later on. A really stupid thing that I've encountered is people say that if you're a doctor, you don't fall ill. They ask you, how come you're falling ill? You're a doctor, right? Let me tell you that we are the ones, even the medical students and the doctors, the ones that are most susceptible to every kind of disease, because we are in the primary contact with the patient who will be suffering. So it's not that we never fall sick. We are the ones who are supposed to fall sick the most. No. We do not learn to take an injection soon after entering a course. All we do in our first year is prick ourselves for the hematology experiments in physiology, and we learn to take a BP. That's all that there is. We do not learn to take an injection first itself. Now this is something that I really want to stress upon, because right when you enter medicine or even when you're a MBBS grad, people just expect you to know everything that there is about every damn subject and every single disease that is there in this world. They just come to you with the reports and start asking you what I must do. People have an overall outlook, but it's not necessary that an MBBS grad needs to know about every subject that there is. So yeah, people think life's set here if you get into MBBS, but it's not true, because there's a long way to go even after you finish your MBBS, and you have your PG, you have your super specialization, everything, and only then you will be getting settled in life, right? So it's not necessary that right after MBBS you're in a good place. So relatives do think that you're going to earn in six figures. Not true at all. It's like any other job, you start slow and keep growing. And unlike any other job, like an engineering job, they get an annual increment and those things, bonuses and those things. But doctors don't get that, so it will take a long time to start earning. Plus, it depends on your specialty. Supposing you've taken radiology as your specialization, you will earn really well, as compared to something else that will not pay that well. MBBS being too costly is right in a way, but supposing you get through merit in a government college, it's really less. The fee is really less, and even if you get through government, if you get a government seat in a private college also, it is pretty less. But if you're going through management, it is higher on that side. So another thing that I've heard is people who get admission through merit are more intelligent and will do well in their college and further on than the people who have come through management. It's not true. There can be a million reasons why they did not get admission through merit. It need not be that they're not intelligent. Probably it was just not their day on the day of the entrance exam, or probably it was just a few ranks here and there. So there can be a lot of reasons, and there are people who do very well even when they've come through management. So that's really not true. So these were the few myths that I have encountered and I've seen around me. And if you guys relate to anything, then just put it in the comment section below. Do subscribe, do like, do share. Thank you guys. Bye.